right, guys, now that you know how to download zip files and copy them and paste them to a new location, you know how to file open them in InDesign, right? Just follow along with the videos, click around when they tell you to click, move panels when they tell you to move them, right? Just practice, make sure you're getting your hands dirty and doing everything they're doing in the video, right? We can watch videos all day long, but we got to get our hands dirty, meaning we got to put our fingers on that mouse and the keyboard. We got to actually do things and practice, right? That way, when we start doing projects in InDesign, we feel comfortable with the interface and we know where things are and we know what to click on and blah, 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 right? Okay, guys, just like in Photoshop, I prefer my tools panel to be a double column, right? InDesign gives you an even other option, right? So it probably defaults to the single column. If you click these double arrows, it's going to change to a single row. If you click the arrows again, it'll change to that double column. I prefer the double column. You use whichever preference you like, right? It's going to default to the single column. I don't like it because I got to go all the way down here to my colors. Right? I'm not fond of a single row because, again, I got to go all the way down here and all the way back. I prefer the double column. I just feel like I can get to things a lot quicker and a lot easier, but that's up to you. All right, guys. Now, again, for me to know that you opened these files and followed along with the videos and took the tour and zoomed in and zoomed out, right? One thing I'm asking you to do is just to type your name on this file. That way, when you save this file and submit it, it's got your name on it. If you submit a file and I open it and it has your name on it, I know for a fact that you opened that file in InDesign because you use the type tool and you put your name on it, right? How do you do that? Just like in Photoshop, find the T tool. Now, Photoshop had some different type tools. InDesign has two. Photoshop had a few. They had type tool, horizontal type tool, vertical type tool, a type on path tool, type in area tool, you know, blah, 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 blah. I will teach you how to type on a path later. So right now, I just need you to make sure you're getting the regular type tool. If you hit T on the keyboard, that tool will show up. It just looks like this regular T, right? Now, guys, look. In Photoshop, this was your foreground color and this was your background color. InDesign does not work that way. It works off a fill and a stroke. So think of it this way. The fill is what goes on the inside and the stroke is what goes on the outside. So if I swapped the fill and stroke, right now I'd have a black fill and no stroke. If I switch those, I'm going to have a no fill with a black stroke. We'll go over this more later. I'll make more videos. Just hang with me. So the best thing for you to do is make sure that this black is the fill. It's in the front. Notice if you hover over it, a balloon pops up and tells you it's the fill, right? If you want to change that color, just double click. Color window comes up, right? You can do it that way. I'm sure you have a swatches panel, right? Maybe we don't, right? But for right now, guys, all I need you to do is make sure that you have a fill. So again, if you open your InDesign and this no is in the front, use those arrows, swap the fill and stroke. We want a black fill. We're not worried about the stroke. And then just type your name, guys. Type your name. Guys, click and drag a text box, my bad. Click and drag a text box. Right. Is this type not working? There we go. Coach Kilmore. Again, guys, if you want to make that bigger, you have your property panel with your characters in it right here. Right? Here's your fill. It's black. We have no stroke. Your font is Minion Pro. It's on regular. Here's the size. So 12 is kind of small. If you want to bump it up. If you want to do other things like making it bold and italic and blah, 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 I don't care, guys. I really don't care. I just want you to put your name on this document. So when I open this file, it's got your name on it. Okay. So how do we make this a JPEG now? InDesign will not file, save as, and give you the JPEG option. It only gives you InDesign. InDesign 2020, 2020 template, or CS4 or later. These are all the old versions. So if you were working with somebody that had an old InDesign, you could save it as the old legacy file for them. So we can't do it under save, right? To make this a JPEG to submit, we have to export. Export means to send out. Import means to bring in, right? So we have to file export. We're going to file export this file. Then we can choose JPEG. As you see, there are a lot of other options. You should be familiar with the PNG. You should be familiar with the PDF, right? You'll learn all these other ones later. Make sure you know where it's going, right? For me, I make this DD1 folder. It's got all my Digital Design 1 stuff in it. Just leave it named tour. You don't need to change the name. They already named it for you. Just hit save, right? Here's your exporting options. You don't need to worry about this too much right now. And then just hit export. Okay. How do you know it worked? Right? Well, you go to that folder location where you had saved your work. For me, it's under Documents in DD1. Right? There it is. There's the tour. If I open it, it should have my name on it. Voila! There's my name. So guys, that's how you do it. Watch the other video I just put in the announcements to show you how to download and copy and paste and open your files in InDesign. And then this video is showing you how to use the type tool, how to type your name, and how to file export as a JPEG. Guys, if you've got any questions, just hit me up in the inbox. I will see you guys in class on Wednesday. No Zoom on Tuesday. I have a meeting, so we will come back to Zoom. On Wednesday, you should have all your work submitted. I should have already taken a look at your work and possibly graded it. So make sure you watch these videos. Make sure you do this work. Make sure you submit those prior to class on Wednesday. All right, guys. Have fun.